Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss the terminology of chain drive. Different terms which is related to chain and chain drive I am going to discuss here. So let's start the discussion of terminology of chain drive. As we know, the chain drive consists one driver and one driven, and that is called sprocket, and the sprocket has tooths on the wheel, so it is called toothed wheel, and the chain is wrapped around this sprocket or toothed wheel. So when the sprocket is rotating in a particular direction, so this chain is wrapped around this sprocket, and chain has holes or recesses into it, so these recesses can fit into this particular tooth, and this chain can fix into this sprocket, and it will provide no slip condition as well as it will provide proper frictional grip, and this chain will also rotate with this driving sprocket, and it is providing motion to the driven sprocket. So this is the basic detail and basic construction of chain drive. Now let's discuss the terminology of chain drive. So in terminology, we consider two terms. One is the pitch of the chain and another is the pitch circle diameter. So these two terms we generally consider as the terminology of chain drive, because this chain is fixed, or we can consider it is in contact with this sprocket gear or spur gear or this sprocket wheel, and it is not moving out from this sprocket wheel. That is why there will be no slip condition. So here we will consider one term which is related to this chain and one term which is related to this sprocket wheel. So the first term which is related to chain is called pitch of the chain. This is the first term of the chain drive. And how we can define the pitch of the chain? Here you can see this diagram. So pitch of the chain we can define from the center distance of two. Here you can see this is our one link, and one end of this particular link is in contact with another link with the help of hinge joint. So here this particular point is in contact with this point with the help of pinch joint. So this particular link is moving with respect to this center, as well as this particular link will also move with respect to same center. It will be like this. So this particular link will move with the same center, and the another link will move with the same center. So here this is one circle or one center we are considering. So this pitch we generally define as the distance between hinge center of two adjacent link. Two hinge center we generally consider. So this is our first link, this is our second link, and if we want to form a chain, so there will be third link also, and from this third link, fourth link will be in contact. So whatever links we are considering, or whatever number of links we are considering, so hinge center is representing the center about which number of links are moving. So the distance between the hinge center of adjacent link, so this particular center is representing the hinge center of first link, and this center is representing the hinge center of the second link, and distance between these two center is representing the pitch of the chain. So pitch of the chain is nothing, it is the center distance of two circle, or distance between two hinge center of the two adjacent link. So this is about the pitch of the chain. Now second term that is related to chain drive, that is pitch circle diameter. So pitch circle diameter we can define on the basis of position of chain with respect to this sprocket wheel or driving wheel or driving pulley. So pitch circle diameter we can define when chain is wrapped around a sprocket. So the diameter of the circle on which hinge center of the chain lie. The construction of the chain and the construction of this sprocket is completely different. Here, as we know, this is our sprocket. And this is the chain. And this is the center about which this sprocket is rotating. And this chain is wrapped around this sprocket. So it is not necessary that chain is in contact with this particular toothed wheel on the diameter only. So the position of the chain and the position of the outer circle or outer diameter of this particular sprocket will be different. So when we are wrapping this chain over this toothed wheel or the sprocket, so the diameter of the circle on which this hinge center of the chain lying, that is called the pitch circle diameter, not the outer diameter of the toothed wheel or toothed sprocket or toothed driving pulley. Here you can see four points A, B, C and D. So these four points are representing the hinge center of the chain. It means this AB is representing the pitch of the chain. As I told you, this is our pitch. So AB, BC, we are considering as the pitch that is represented as the distance between the hinge center of the adjacent link. So this AB is representing the pitch of the chain and this point A and point B are representing the hinge center of the chain. And here, if we are considering number of hinge center or number of end point of the chain or number of links, so the circle drawn or circle which is passing through these hinge center when we are wrapping this chain over the sprocket gear or sprocket wheel, that is represented as the pitch circle diameter. It will not be the diameter of this sprocket or the outer diameter of this particular toothed wheel. So this is all about the pitch circle diameter. And here you can see point A, B, C and D are representing the hinge center of the chain. So about whatever center we are considering, the rotation of these hinge center of this chain, here if we are considering center O, so this OA is representing as the radius of this circle and this OB is also representing the radius of the circle. So if we are forming or if we are joining all these points with the help of circle, so this complete distance between two ends here, if we are considering A and D, so the distance between A and D is called the this particular it is represented by D. So this D is representing the pitch circle diameter. So pitch circle diameter is the diameter of this complete circle, which is made by these different points A, B, C, D, or the circle formed with the help of joining of these different points. So the diameter of this circle is called the pitch circle diameter. Now if we want to define the relation between pitch and pitch circle diameter, so we will use same diagram here. As we know, this point A, B, C, D and so on, these are representing the number of hinge center for the chain. And here, this AB, BC, CD and other lines are representing the number of links of the chain. Now we want to define the relation between pitch and pitch circle diameter. So this AB is representing pitch And this D is representing pitch circle diameter. Now we are forming a circle by joining these number of hinge center. So here we have this circle, and center of the circle we are considering as O. This O is representing the center of the circle. And this center we can also consider the center of rotation or the center of the sprocket toothed wheel, about which that toothed wheel is rotating, and the chain is also rotating with that particular center. So here A, B, C, D are the hinge center of the chain. Now AO is representing the radius of the circle. Similarly, BO is also representing the radius of the circle. Now if we are considering this triangle ABO, so this AB is not representing the radius of the circle. It is not equals to AO. So this AB is representing the chord of the circle. Similarly, this BC, CD, and if we are considering other point, so DE, EF are representing the chord of the circle, and it will not equals to radius of the circle. Now, if we want to define the relation between pitch, so this AB is representing the pitch of the circle, and pitch circle diameter we can consider as 2AO. 2AO means AO plus OD. OD is representing the radius, so 2AO. So this 2AO is representing the pitch circle diameter. And in that case, we can say this OA and OB will be equivalent. So here, if we are considering AB as the chord and it is subtended the angle theta, if we are joining these two points A and B with center O, so it is forming one angle, and that angle if we are considering as theta, so this AB is subtending angle theta. Now if we want to define the value of this AB, so from this triangle OAB, here we have this angle theta, and it is not right angle triangle. So we will divide this triangle into two parts. So this angle will be 90, this angle will be 90 here, and half of the angle will be theta by 2. So here we will define this half part of AB and this half part of AB with the help of two right angle triangles. So it will become 2AO sine theta by 2. Here let us consider this point P. So these two distances we have to find, AP and BP. So from this triangle OAP and BOP, we will define this AP and BP. So here this AP we will define in terms of sine theta. So it will be AP divided by AO, that is equals to sine theta by 2. This should be theta by 2, and this angle will also theta by 2. So this AP will be in terms of sine theta. So AP, that is equals to AO sine theta by 2, and this BP from this triangle, it will be BP divided by BO sine theta by 2, and this BO and AO are equivalent. So this AB will be equivalent to 2AO sine theta by 2. So here we have the value of AB. Now we know this AO is representing the radius of the circle, so it will be half of the diameter, where D is the pitch circle diameter. Here this D is representing the pitch circle diameter, so radius will be D by 2 only. So we will put this AB equals to 2 into D by 2 sine theta by 2. So it will be equal to D sine theta by 2, and this AB is representing the pitch. So pitch length we can define with the help of this equation d sine theta by 2. So here we have the equation to define the pitch of the chain. Now let us consider there are number of teeth in the sprocket. So let us consider T number of teeth in the sprocket. So here, if we want to define the value of theta, theta is representing the angle AOB. That is representing the angle which is subtended by this one chord. Now we are considering T number of teeth in the sprocket. So this theta we can define on the basis of these number of teeth on the sprocket. And pitch circle diameter we are defining with the help of circle. So the pitch circle diameter we have D. And this is the circle which we are considering. It is made by these hinge center of the chain. So here, if we want to define the value of theta, so we can define on the basis of this circle. And this chain or this hinge center of the chain are connected with different tooths of this sprocket. So value of theta we can define on the basis of complete angle of the circle. And the complete angle we consider 360 degree. So if we want to define 1 theta, in that case, it will be 360 divided by number of teeth in the sprocket. So it will be 360 by T. If we have 1 teeth, in that case, the angle will be 360 only. Or if we have no teeth, in that case, angle will be 360. But we are considering number of teeth on the sprocket where chain is wrapped around. That is why the value of theta is represented as 360 by T. So we will put this value of theta in this previous equation. So AB will be 180 by T. Here 360 by 2T, so it will be D sine 180 by T. So we can define the pitch circle diameter with the help of this equation, and pitch circle diameter we will define in terms of pitch of the chain. So the pitch circle diameter in terms of P or pitch, it is P cosec 180 by T. So by this way, we can define the relation between the pitch circle diameter and the pitch of the chain. It will be represented by this equation D equals to P cosec 180 by T. And this equation we will use to solve different numericals which is related to concepts of chain drive. So this is the relation between pitch and pitch circle diameter. Now, if we want to define the relation between chain speed and the angular velocity of sprocket, so same diagram we will use here. As we know, these number of points, as you can see here in the circle, if we are considering n number of teeth on the sprocket, and sprocket is a wheel and it will rotate about a center, so it will have some angular velocity, and chain is wrapped around this particular sprocket wheel, so chain will have a particular speed in a definite direction. So A, B, C, D, E, F and so on, these points are representing the hinge center of the chain. And when this hinge center of the chain are in contact with the sprocket, so at whatever speed the chain is moving, we can define the relation between the chain speed with the angular velocity of this sprocket wheel. The sprocket wheel will also rotate with some angular velocity or with some velocity. So we can define the relation between the speed of the chain as well as the angular velocity of sprocket. So here you can see two diagrams which is representing the chain and the sprocket and the rotation of sprocket as well as the motion of the chain. So here if we are considering this first diagram, so point A is the extreme point of this pitch circle diameter which is representing one hinge center of the chain or link of the chain. So at whatever speed this particular sprocket is rotating, in that condition these extreme points are continuously changed, and here this angle theta is representing the angle which is made by or which is substanded by this arc AB or the chord AB. So this angle theta we are considering, this particular angle between two which is made by these two end or these two hinge center of this particular chain. Now when at whatever speed this wheel is rotating or sprocket is rotating, so for that speed this hinge center is also changing its position. It means the speed of this hinge center is also changing with respect to rotation of this sprocket. So we can define the speed of the chain as well as the angular velocity of this sprocket with angular change in position or change in angular position of this sprocket. So change in angular position of this sprocket is generally defining both the speed of the chain as well as the angular velocity of the sprocket. This particular diagram is representing initial condition when A is the extreme point, and here this particular diagram you can see at this point, point C is representing the extreme position. So here extreme position is different, and at this particular point extreme position is different. In that case we can say the angular position of the sprocket is continuously changing. In that condition the hinge centers of the chain is also changing. So with the change in angular position, the speed of both the parts, either it is chain or it is sprocket, it will continuously change. So here we will define the angular velocity or the velocity of the chain for this particular condition as well as for this particular condition. For both the condition the velocities will be different because there is a change in angular position we are considering here. So let us consider figure 1. Here point A is representing the extreme position and AO is representing the radius of this particular circle. So if we want to define the velocity of the chain by changing the angular position of this sprocket, so this V is representing the velocity of chain, so it will be equals to omega into OA because this chain is also moving with rotation of this sprocket. So we will consider angular velocity of sprocket here, and this V we consider omega into R. So this OA is representing the R, so it will be equals to omega into OA. Where omega is the angular velocity of sprocket. And OA is representing the radius of pitch circle. Now when the position of the sprocket is changing or angular position of the sprocket is changing. For example, here this rotation is in this particular direction. In clockwise direction. So A will change its position toward here. B will change its position toward here. Now, if we are considering point C is in the extreme position. So, point A will change its position here and it will move with the chain in this particular direction. And this point B will also move further in the direction of A in this particular direction. Now, let us consider point C is the extreme position. So at this point we will consider B and after that we will consider point A. So in this condition when two chords are collinear, In that condition, if we want to define the velocity of chain. So for that condition, we can define the velocity of chain for this figure 2. So from figure 2, as you can see here, this x is representing the point, the midpoint, or we can consider the point on this curve or on this circle for the position of C. You can see this point x. This point x is representing from point O, this OX is representing the radius of the circle, and for the change position, because this CD and BC are in the collinear, here we are considering CD and BC are collinear. So this OX is representing the line which is perpendicular on CD. So this OX we will consider as the radius of the circle, because here this AO is the straight line. In this particular term, we are considering when A is the extreme position. So in this condition, AO will be the radius. So for second condition, the radius we will consider as OX. So this OX we can define by the same term from the triangle. So it will be So this velocity of the chain will be, for the second condition, it will be omega into OC from the same triangle, OC cos theta by 2. And here OC is equivalent to OA, because OC is the radius and OA is the radius. So it can be equivalent to omega into OA cos theta by 2 from the previous triangle. So this is the relation between chain speed and the angular velocity of sprocket. Here, on the basis of angular position or the change in angular position of the sprocket, we can define the speed of the chain as well as the angular velocity of the sprocket. Thank you so much.